a Sherpa in the high. So I'm gonna get through this. Maybe you'll move it, but either way I get through it. So help me, God, I'm gonna get through this. So help me, God.
Blessings day in.
like something is wrong here, like you don't belong here. It's not just you. Do you look at a night sky full of stars and feel an aching in your heart? I feel it too. We might be here for now, but don't forget where we're going. Gonna trade this world for a better place. Gonna wave goodbye to the hurt and the pain. We'll dance on streets of gold when we get where we're going. Gonna see what our hearts have known forever. We were not made for here. We were made for heaven.
Good morning, everyone. Could you please stand with us as we begin worship, please? How's everybody doing today? Good? Good? Good morning? All right. Are y'all ready to worship? All right. Let's get into it.
Lost your hold on me. worship our King. Come, let us bow at His feet. He has done great things. See what our Savior has done. See how His love overcomes. He has done great things. He has done great things. O hero of heaven, You conquered the grave. You free every captive and break every chain, O God. You have done great things. We dance in Your freedom, awake and alive. O Jesus, our Savior, Your name lifted high, O God. You have done great things. Storm. You'll be faithful forevermore. You have done great things, and I know You will do it again. For Your promise is yes and amen. You have done great things, God. You do great things.
Conquered the grave, You free every captive and break every chain, oh God. You have done great things. We dance in Your freedom, awake and alive. Oh Jesus, our Savior, Your name lifted high, oh God. You have done great things.
God above it all, hallelujah, God unshakable, hallelujah, You have done great things. And hallelujah, God above it all, hallelujah, God unshakable, hallelujah, You have done great things. You've done great things.
O hero of heaven, You conquered the grave. You free every captive and break every chain, oh God. You have done great things. We dance in Your freedom, awake and alive. Oh Jesus, our Savior, Your name lifted high, oh God.
You have done great things. You have done great things. Oh God, You do great things.
Father, Lord, we just come to You today saying, God, You do great things, God. And as we get to this point in the semester where we're dragging, God, I pray that we learn what it means to just continue to pour into You and lean into You, God, in worship. And I pray that today we are just able to show each other how to worship through unconventional ways, like not necessarily just song, God, but through Your word, God, and how we read it. I just pray that You bless all these students here, and it's in Jesus' name I pray. Amen. You may be seated.
There we go. Yeah.
Rely on the blonde to figure out how to turn something on. It doesn't work. So we're going to do something pretty special for our chapel rotation for worship this week. And so we have the Bible, and that's our gift from God. It's His word, but it can be a little overwhelming. There's a lot in it. There's so many years of history covered in it, so many things of teaching in it. And so today we just wanted to kind of give y'all just some tools to be able to read through your Bible and just see what God is speaking to you. So we're going to kind of give y'all an opportunity to practice that today, and then also just to kind of know how to do it on your own. But before we do that, we are going to do something that's a little bit awkward, because silence is always a little awkward when it starts, right? That's just how it works. And so we really want to take an opportunity to invite God into this space. And to do that, we do have to be fully open and willing to listen to Him. And so I'm going to pull up a passage. It's in 1 Kings. 1 Kings chapter 19, verses 9 through 13. We're going to start at the end of verse 9, and it says, "And the word of the Lord came to him, 'What are you doing here, Elijah?' He replied, 'I have been very zealous for the Lord God Almighty. The Israelites have rejected your covenant, torn down your altars, and put your prophets to death with the sword. I am the only one left, and now they are trying to kill me too.' The Lord said, 'Go out and stand on the mountain in the presence of the Lord, for the Lord is about to pass by.' Then a great and powerful wind tore the mountains apart and shattered the rocks before the Lord. But the Lord was not in the wind. And after the wind, there was an earthquake. But the Lord was not in the earthquake. After the earthquake came a fire, but the Lord was not in the fire. And after the fire came a gentle whisper. When Elijah heard it, he pulled his cloak over his face and went out and stood at the mouth of the cave." So God didn't come in the fire. He didn't come in the earthquake. He didn't come in the wind. He's a big God, but He didn't make Himself known to Elijah through these big events. He wanted to speak personally to him and give him that small voice. So in order to hear that small voice, we have to block out all of the chaos and the craziness and the loudness of life. And so even though it's something that we don't really like to do a whole lot of the time, I'd encourage you to take this moment and just be fully present in this space and be fully present and willing and open for the Lord to come in and speak to you. God, we thank you for this opportunity to be here, Lord, and to get to spend time in your word, God. I just pray that you would help us to fully rely on you during this time and to put all of our focus and all of our time into you, God. I ask that you would speak to us during this time and just allow us to see you through the scripture as we read it. It's in your name we pray. Amen. So after we spend some time just in silence and coming into the presence of the Lord, we will read through our passage. And today we've picked out Psalm 23. So we'll just read through that. And this first time that we read through it, we will read through it several times. But the first time that we do it, I just want you to listen and see what word or phrase God puts on your heart. And listen to what He's saying to you. I don't want you to worry about what the word means or worry about what the phrase may be saying to you, but just listen for that word or phrase as it is in the passage.
A Psalm of David. The Lord is my shepherd. I lack nothing. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside quiet waters. He refreshes my soul. He guides me along the right paths for His name's sake. Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Surely your goodness and love will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
In just a moment, we'll read through that passage again. And this time, I want you to think about that word or phrase that God said on your heart that last time when we read it. And just as we read it, I want you to listen for the invitation that God's handing to you, that he's extending to you through that word or phrase. I want you to reflect on the importance of those words and just explore that invitation that God gives you and think about what it means, and think about what it means for you, and just think about why that phrase is what God said on your heart.
The Lord is my shepherd. I lack nothing. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside quiet waters. He refreshes my soul. He guides me along the right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Surely your goodness and love will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
In just a moment, we'll read through the passage one final time. And at this point, I want you to continue that process that you had just a minute ago and thinking through why God laid that passage on your heart, what it means for you, or that word or phrase. And then after that, we will have another period of silence where I just want you to enter into conversation with God, go into prayer with him. And there's no right or wrong way to do this. We just want you to respond truthfully and authentically to him. We want you to think about and talk with him about what feelings the text brought up in you. Talk about where you're resistant or want to push back and what he's teaching you and showing you. And just become aware of where you feel invited into a deeper way of being with God. And so just talk with God about these feelings, and you're welcome to make notes on your phone, or if you have pencil and paper with you, you can just talk about that phrase or word that stuck out to you, and just why God put it on your heart, and after you have that conversation with him. So we'll read it one more time, and then we'll go into that time of doing that.
The Lord is my shepherd. I lack nothing. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. He refreshes my soul. He guides me along the right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Surely your goodness and your love will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
if you're still in that time of meditation and prayer and just thinking about what God's shown you, please continue that. We don't want to interrupt that. Just continue to take that time for yourself. The great thing about this way of reading devotionally, of reading through the passage so many times and seeing what God's laid on your heart and meditating on that, is that you can do it on your own. But there are also some great benefits of being in a room with people, and being able to do it with them is that you can also get other perspectives and other people just sharing what God's doing with them and what God's showing them. And so I'm going to take a few moments just to share what God laid on my heart during this time. So verse 2 of the psalm says, "He makes me lie down in green pastures and or in green meadows," in this translation. Other translations will say that he makes me rest. And I'm definitely a person who likes to keep myself very busy. And I almost look at rest as a bad thing, like, oh, you're not supposed to do that. You're supposed to continue going and going and going. But if we go back to the book of Genesis, right after creation, we can see that God gave us the example of take time to rest. God didn't need to rest. He didn't need to take a break from what he was doing. He's all-knowing. He's all-powerful. He never had to take a second to stop. But he knows that his creation does. And so in Genesis 2, verse 2, it talks about God's gone through all 6 days. He's made everything. He's given us the earth, the sun, the stars, the moon, the sky, the water. He's given us land. He's given us all of the animals and the plants, and he's put humans on the earth, and then he takes a day to rest. And so God gave us that example for us to follow, and he made us knowing that he was going to give us that time to rest as well. And so a big thing for me is that this whole psalm talks about God's provision and how God's going to take care of us. And so when I think about this phrase, like, he makes me rest, like, God's going to provide for me to have opportunities to take care of things, but he's also going to provide those opportunities for me to rest if I'll trust him and have the willingness to do as he tells me to. He refreshes and he renews us, and he is that source of rest for us.
So what I got out of it was actually in verse 4, "Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your darkest valley, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me." So how many of you in here are, whether it just be like, you know, just struggling with your classes or just going through a time of trial in your life? Show of hands. Yeah, that's quite a bit of you, and those of you who aren't raising your hands probably will at some point in life. But the fact of the matter is, this verse does not tell us that those things won't happen. How many of y'all have heard the phrase, God won't give you more than you can handle? I don't necessarily think that is always completely true. Sometimes I think God will give you harder situations in your life so that you draw closer to him. It says, "I fear no evil, for you are with me." It doesn't say that that evil will never come in your life, that bad things won't happen. But instead, it says, "You are with me, your rod and your staff, they comfort me." So God, like a shepherd, is leading us through those hard times. And through those hard times, he wants us to lean in closer to him.
So what we're going to do now, I'm going to ask the worship team to come back on up here. And in just a moment, we're going to play a song of reflection. You're welcome to participate and stand up and sing and worship. If you want to, you're welcome to sit if you want to and just continue in that time of meditation. You're really welcome to just respond however God's calling you to, whether that is participating in worship or just listening to the words or continuing to be in prayer with him, however you feel called to worship. And so as they're making their way back up, I'm just going to pray for us. And then after that song of reflection, we will have one more song of worship before we'll dismiss y'all. So let's bow in prayer. God, we just thank you that you've given us this time, Lord. Thank you that you desire to have that relationship with us, God, and that you've given us the ability to seek you, Lord. I pray that you would give us the motivation to just continue to chase after you, God. And I just pray that we would continue to be invested in your word and diving deep into knowing you more. Thank you that you've given us this opportunity to spend in worship, Lord, and spend just getting to know you better. And we pray that you will continue to do that in our regular lives. It's in your name we pray. Amen.
Been a moment you were forgotten. You are not hopeless. Though you have been broken, your innocence stolen, I hear you whisper underneath your breath. I hear your SOS, your SOS. Darkest night, it's true, I will rescue you. And there is no distance that cannot be covered over and over. You're not defenseless. And I'll be your shelter, I'll be your armor. Hear you whisper underneath your breath. I hear your SOS, your SOS. And I will send out an army to find you in the middle of the darkest. I will rescue you. Oh. And I will never stop marching to reach you in the middle of the hardest fight. It's true. Oh, I will rescue you. I hear you whisper under darkest night, it's true. Oh, I will rescue you. And I will never stop marching to reach you in the middle of the hardest fight. It's true. Oh, I will.
never fails me. All my days I've been held in your hands. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, I will sing of the goodness of God. All my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God. I love your voice. You have led me through the fire and darkness. Like no other, I've known you as a father, I've known you as a friend, and I have lived in the goodness of God. And all my life you have been faithful, and all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. With my life down, I'm surrendered now. I give you everything. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. With my life laid down, I'm surrendered now. You everything. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. All my life you have been faithful. All my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am, we just thank you for today. We thank you that you've given us this chance to be here and to spend time in worship and spend time in your word, God. I pray that we would honor you and glorify you and show people who you are as we go throughout the rest of our day. And I pray that you would continue to encourage us and continue to motivate us to do everything for you, God. We thank you just for giving us today. It's in your name we pray. Amen. Y'all are dismissed.
They think that I'm all by myself in this fight, but they do not know the infinite size of the God who is by my side. Hey, under fire, but my Goliath, standing in the shadow of the Almighty. I ain't lying, just testifying. Man, I'm talking about a big God, big God. When trouble comes around, When I know that he holds my world in his hands, the monsters I face don't make me afraid when I